So we came to the bar. It was full of people. They were laughing, drinking, and I didn't understand what the hell I was doing there. People stood squeezed like tuna in a can. There was nowhere to sit, and we just struck the wall like complete fools. Two men invited us to sit next to them. We didn't have much choice, so we joined them. After a while, one of those men brought us a drink. My friend asked me, "Isn't it a good feeling when someone offers you a drink?" I agreed. It was great, but only because it made me feel beautiful and coveted as all the other girls my age for the first time in my life. That night, my drink was weak and sad. I'm 21, and it's the first time I'm in the bar. To my peers, I looked like a freak who had lived under a rock. I had never been drunk, never smoked a cigarette. I hadn't even kissed a guy yet. Have I lived all these years at all? Those men we were sitting with invited us to go to another bar, but I didn't want to leave. Because here was that guy we liked for half a year. I'll be lying if I said we didn't come there because of him. I often liked someone, but there were only a few of them throughout my life. I like choosing a subject of sympathy to experience all the love and relationship passions in my head. Experiencing all this in my mind was far safer than in reality. At any time, I could come back and not be hurt. Reality could not promise me that. I drank more and more, but didn't feel any effect. A few more friends joined us. When they went smoking, I was with them all the way to them smoke that night. Those few minutes while I was standing in the circle of smokers were helping me to get to know him better. Hypnotized, I looked how smoke flies from his lips, separating us with an indestructible wall of fog. Drunk, he looked at our girls as if he wanted each of them, and I felt pleased and happy because he also looked at me like that, without exception. When I got back to the bar, I saw a girl dancing with some guy. She was wrapped around him like a snake. They kissed, he lifted her up. It's strange to see how two people get crazy about each other. It's like watching Crescent City. Every second it gets smaller and smaller, but only you feel it's really you getting smaller and smaller and lonelier, lonelier. And move away from all those lights and passions of the city. I always felt far away from all this, as if I were looking at the world through a window in which it was glittering and blinking, but also frozen and flat as a coaster. And I knew the cars were making noise, people in them, and the people floating were making noise. And the wind, birds, river were all making noise. But it could all have been just my dream. And each time I woke up, I find myself in a black silence. The silence depressed me. It wasn't the silence of silence. It was my own silence. I remember I felt numb at my grandpa's funeral. I listened to my mother cry and absorbed the people gathered. I watched the most important man in my life laying in a coffin, surrounded by bouquets of flowers, and the only thing I could think about was, why did no one bring him flowers and didn't even visit him while he was alive? Maybe we can be remembered and receive flowers only when we're gone. Then a deep pit was dug in the hard and cold ground, and I realized it's the only end we get. Shadows and sunlight were dancing on a freshly buried grave. Grown flowers covered the black mound on the ground. I took a deep breath and listened to the old break of my heart.
Thank you. Africa and South America. And from an African is an open fighting
I want to be everything. I want to be everything. I want to be everything. I want to disappear.
When someone asked some poet how he wanted to die, he answered he would cut his veins in a warm bath. I thought it must be pretty, laying in the warm tub and seeing water among you turning red, like if you were laying in the field of flaming poppies and slowly falling asleep. It must be so easy. So I lay myself in a warm bath. I look at my wrists. They look so helpless and fragile that I can't do it. Somehow it seems as if I want to kill something, but it's not in that skin I'm going to cut. It's somewhere deeper, more secret, harder to find and to reach. I'm laying in a bath until my skin wrinkles terribly. I feel like I am becoming pure again. The bath helps me solve almost all troubles. When I am deadly sad, anxious, can't sleep, or am in love with someone whom I will never talk to in my life, I lay in the bath as in a peaceful coffin. The water must be so hot that when it touches my skin, everything disappears into oblivion. And I think, people are vanishing, the city is vanishing, life is vanishing. I don't know anything, I don't recognize anyone. The world and its dirt set over my skin comes off and turns into something better. probably too often imagining what it would be like if I disappeared. Nowhere looks like a good place to go. It must be great. Death must be beautiful. To have no tomorrow, no yesterday, no worries, no sorrow. To forget our mistakes, to forgive life.
Thank you.
Sometimes I wake up in the morning wanting to believe everything was just a bad dream. A bad dream. To the person in the bell jar, blank and stabbed as a dead baby, the world itself is a bad dream. I remember everything. I remember dead bodies, my dad, my grandpa, those men at the bar, story about the fig tree. I wish oblivion, like a cute and fluffy snow, could freeze and cover up my memories. But it's part of me. It's the landscape of my soul.